Hi, James from NCC. Welcome back to our channel again. Today we're going to unravel the inner workings of the Internet Protocol or IP. Specifically, we'll cover how IP addressing, subnetting and routing make it all possible. Before we get started, if you missed any of our previous videos, click up here and you'll be taken to the playlist. Right, let's get on with it. First, let's talk about IP addressing. Every device on the network needs a unique identifier, and that's where IP addresses come in. Think of it, think of an IP address as a postal address for your device, allowing it to send and receive data. An IP address is made up of two parts, a network part and a host part. In IPv4, an IP address looks something like this. Now the first part, 192.168.1 identifies the network, while the last part, the .1, identifies the specific device or host on that network. Now let's move on to subnetting. Now subnetting is the process of dividing a larger network into smaller, more manageable subnetworks or subnets. This helps improve network performance and security by isolating segments of the network. Now when you subnet a network, you extend the network part of the IP address. For example, if we take the IP address 192.168.1.0/24, the /24 indicates that the first 24 bits are used by the network, leaving the remaining bits for the host. Subnetting allows network administrators to create multiple smaller networks within a larger one. Now this can help reduce congestion and improve security by controlling traffic between subnets. Finally, let's talk about routing. Routing is the process of moving data packets from one network to another. Routers are the devices responsible for this task. They determine the best path for data to travel based on the destination IP address. When data is sent from one device to another, it is broken down into smaller units called packets. Each packet contains the source and destination IP address. Routers use the addresses to forward the packets along the most efficient path until they reach their destination. On the other hand, we have private IP addresses. And private IP addresses are used within local networks, such as your home or office network. Now these addresses are not directly accessible from the internet and are typically assigned by a router or a network administrator. Private IP addresses are essential for internal communication within a network, while public IP addresses enable communication with devices outside the network, such as a web server or an email server. Understanding the difference between public and private addresses is crucial for network administrators and security. By properly configuring network devices, you can ensure efficient communication while protecting sensitive data from unauthorized access. And there you have it, folks. A rundown of the different types of IP addresses, IPv4, IPv6, public and private addresses. If you found this video helpful, be sure to give it a thumbs up, subscribe to our channel, and hit the bell icon for more tech insights. Thanks for watching our video. See you in the next one.